trouble in your life. What does it mean if you have a serious heart condition? What does it mean if you have diabetes? What does it mean if you have any one of a number of life-threatening diseases that you need to take? That the Republican Congress wants to take away the insurance that is keeping you alive.
That's right.
What happens to you if you are dealing with a life-threatening disease, if you're in radiation?
You die.
You're expendable.
What happens to you if your health insurance is taken away and you cannot afford to go to the doctor when you're sick?
You die.
What happens to you if you cannot afford to buy the medications that keep you alive? What happens if you have no health insurance and you have a heart attack or a stroke, something that happens every day? And the horrible and unspeakable answer is that if this legislation were to pass, many thousands of our fellow Americans will die, and many more will suffer and become much sicker than they should. Now that is not Bernie Sanders' fault. That is what study after study after study shows. A couple of weeks ago, I was on a television show and I made the point that people by the thousands will die if this disastrous legislation were to be passed. And then many Republicans and my right-wing critics jumped up. They said, you know, Bernie Sanders is exaggerating. He's frightening the American people. Well, there's an organization called PolitiFact. And they are a nonpartisan group that checks out public officials, like Bernie Sanders says. And they took a look at over a dozen different studies that looked at the issue of mortality rates and lack of insurance coverage. What does it mean in terms of your mortality if your insurance is taken away from you? And what they concluded is that what I said was well supported. Now, obviously, nobody can predict exactly how many people will die if they lose their coverage. Nobody can make that prediction. But what experts at the Harvard School of Public Health estimate is that if 23 million Americans were to be thrown off the insurance they currently have, which is what the House bill would do, up to 28,000 Americans every single year could die. That is 9 times more than the tragic losses we suffered on 9/11 every single year. In the wealthiest country in the history of the world, we must not allow that to happen.
Providing them with coverage so that they can live in security